Let me be the one to break the silence. That was the most offensive thing I've seen in 20 years of teaching, and that includes an elementary school production of Hair.
Hello everyone, I'm Mark Daniel Patrick. Thank you so much for checking out the channel. First things first, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and then go check out our Patreon page, which is at the link below. We have some great reaction videos there, and new ones going up each and every week. You can also find me on Instagram, at Mark Daniel Patrick. I cannot begin to tell you how much musical theater kids owe to Ryan Murphy and the entire cast and crew behind Glee. A career in the arts is never an easy road, especially from a young age. Doubt, ridicule, and being judged every single day of your life. All for a dream that one day you'll get to stand on stage, tell your story, and share your talent with the world. Glee gave theater kids the most accurate depiction of how simultaneously painful and beautiful life in high school and in the arts can be. So to celebrate everything Glee has given us, we're counting down the top 10 performances of each and every season. So let's start at the very beginning, because it's a very good place to start. Your season 1 top 10 starts now.
For the broken hearted.
Coming in at number 10, It's My Life and Confessions. If only we all could take a pill that turns us into a rock star.
It's my life, it's now or never.
Episode 6 from season 1, aptly titled Vitamin D, showcases the first real breakout performance of the male side of New Direction. Slightly overacted from our leading frontman, but this number makes our top 10 to reward whatever pill the music directors took to successfully mash up Bon Jovi and Usher. At number 9, Take a Bow.
Trying to apologize, you're so ugly when you cry, please.
Forever thinking the world is punishing her. A rhetoric we understood loud and clear by episode number 2. I admittedly had a tough time deciding between Take a Bow and On My Own for the number 9 spot, because Lea Michelle just has an uncanny ability to make any song sound like it was meant for musical theater. Despite Rihanna discounting her licensing fees, no doubt Glee still had to shell out a gold brick or two to land this track. So yeah, we'll put it in our top 10.
But it's over now.
At number 8, Dancing with Myself.
On the floor of Tokyo.
Number 8 and number 7 on our list happen to come from the same episode. Episode number 9 is one of my personal favorites, titled Wheels.
Dancing with myself. Well, there's nothing to lose and there's nothing.
In just one 23-minute episode, this show covers those living with mobility issues, those living with Down syndrome, and breaking down gender roles and stereotypes.
Dancing with myself. Oh, dancing with myself. Oh,
the character of Artie, portrayed flawlessly by Kevin McHale, kicks off this episode by showing us he's truly one of the show's most gifted vocalists.
Improving, I'll be dancing with myself.
Coming in at number 7, Defying Gravity.
Something has changed within me. Something is not the same.
Again, not only a number that comes from my favorite episode of Glee, but quite possibly one of my favorite musical theater numbers of all time.
Close my eyes and leap.
To be honest, good on the show for not waiting to give this song to the obvious Idina Menzel, who shows up later in season 1, but instead using this number as an inspiring, teachable moment by tackling gender roles and sexuality head on.
Too long I've been afraid of losing love. I guess I've lost.
between Chris's falsetto, Lea's belt, and a music tempo that screams we need to go to commercial, this number should be a mainstay in anyone's top 10.
My name is Mercedes Jones, and I'm singing R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
Coming in at number 6, Respect.
What you want, baby?
Originally sung by the Queen of Soul, this number showing up in the pilot episode was beyond the perfect introduction, not only to Mercedes' character, but the insane vocal prowess that is Riley.
R-E-S-P-E-C-T, find out what it means to me.
True, she has an unlimited number of standout performances from this first season, as she shows up again in our top 10. But Aretha is so on my mind lately, I couldn't help but feature this, albeit short, but incredible cover. At number 5, Rehab. Taking a heartbreaking, depressing song about drug addiction and rehab and turning it into a show-stopping show choir dance tune. Yeah, seems about right. Now for anyone who just said, but this isn't even New Direction, you're lucky this song isn't number 1 on our list. And spoiler alert, this isn't the last time you'll see Vocal Adrenaline make our top 5. Taken from the pilot episode, this was hands down the number that woke me from the couch and shouted, "You're gonna love this show." Finally, network television giving us a high quality look at the high school gleeks we either all made fun of, or in my case, all wanted to be. The only problem with this number is our Glee Club leads never came even close to producing a show-stopping number like this all season long. At number 4, Single Ladies. Possibly one of the biggest low-budget MVs we've seen in decades, and of course, it would belong to Queen Bee. And although they don't let Kurt attempt to sing this number, once again they blend gender roles and highlight the importance of acceptance all in one number. For that reason alone, I would put this moment in my top 5 unapologetically over and over. The show even goes as far to let the McKinley football team have a stab at the dance number. So, two things here. Firstly, number 34 absolutely slays that dance, so whoever you are, we see you. Secondly, as any half-hearted football fan will tell you, that play would have actually resulted in a false start and a 5-yard penalty, but, you know. Moving on.
Do I even need to tell you a song?
At number 3, And I'm Telling You.
And I am telling you, I'm not going.
As promised, Riley grabs another spot in our countdown, even cracking the podium at number 3.
There's no way I can ever go. No, no, there's no way.
Now, if you thought her Aretha cover was spot on, midway through the first season, our Glee showrunners clearly tell us, oh, you ain't seen nothing yet. It's one of the biggest ballads musical theater has ever seen. And not to start any unnecessary drama, but hindsight and recent revelations may give us a clue into what Riley was thinking as she stares down Lea Michelle performing this number. At the end of the day, Riley rivals any vocalist that came before her with this stirring cover, and is more than deserving of a top 3 finish.
Is this the real life? Is this
At number 2, Bohemian Rhapsody. Another promise kept as Vocal Adrenaline hits another spot in our top 5. This time, playing their trump card, the incomparable Jonathan Groff.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my...
While nobody can ever touch the godlike vocals of Freddie Mercury, Groff Sauce does his best part in giving Adam Lambert a little taste of Anything You Can Do.
If I'm not back again this time tomorrow.
The song adequately serves as the final performance of the season and gives us some flashes into the birth of Quinn's daughter, a pregnancy that dominated the storylines of season 1.
Can't do this to me, baby. Just gotta get out. Just gotta get right out of here.
To the show's credit, judges do reward Vocal Adrenaline for such a performance, while New Direction finishes rightfully dead last.
Anyone can see, nothing really...
And finally, that brings us to the number 1 spot of the season. Now, obviously, this is an imperfect list. There's no way to actually rank all 99 musical numbers of the first season, and everyone's going to have a highlight or a memory that really stood out for them. However, based on the early success of the pilot and the first few episodes of the season, one of the biggest names in music opened up her entire songbook for the show to pick and choose pretty much anything they wanted to use. Obviously, show creators took that offer and ran with it, even giving this vocalist an entire episode dedicated to just her music. And what that gave us was the most unexpected, unimaginable number of the first season, featuring one of the characters you'd least expect to look and sound so good.
Vogue, take 1. Sound, speed, and action. And playback.
And coming in at number 1, Vogue. I cannot wait to hear everyone screaming in the comments, but look, it's almost a shot-for-shot remake of the original music video by Madonna. The one character who wants nothing more than Glee Club to burn to the ground actually steps up and delivers a flawless performance herself. Sue Sylvester offers up her triple threat suitcase for the highlight of the season. Now, Jane Lynch is not only an incredible actor, singer, comedian, and a half-decent dancer, but she could apparently also make Madonna herself the runner-up at a Madonna lookalike contest.